Hammer throw gold medalist Gwen Berry raised her fist.
Raised a fist to protest social injustice.
So last summer at the Pan American Games, I threw 74 meters and I won gold. Something came over me. I raised my fist. I felt like I was not at peace with myself if I had not said something or did something in that moment. So Rule 50 is a rule in the Olympic Charter that states that athletes cannot demonstrate any type of political, religious, or racial propaganda in the field of play or on the podium at the Olympic Games. Here are the IOC board members who are enforcing the rule. So the idea of white people telling black people exactly what they can and cannot say or do is exactly why I protested.
What's important to know here is that Gwendolyn Berry's protesting at the national level gained her the right to protest at any game at the national level. She is now seeking to protest at the international level at the Tokyo Games.
Standing up for what you believe, pushing for impossible dreams, that is the Olympic spirit. I'm ready for Tokyo 2021 and my next podium. And when I get there, I want to be able to raise my fist and my voice without being punished.
Hammer thrower Gwen Berry turning away from the American flag as the national anthem played at the Olympic trials in Oregon.
Me being able to represent my communities and my people and those who have died at the hands of police brutality, those who have died to this system.
Of course we can protest outside the Olympic Village, but who will see that?
Go participate in your backyard. Go to your YMCA and compete in hammer throwing if that's what you want. But if you're gonna wear the flag, the United States of America, and represent us as a country, then you're gonna have to be okay to put the red, white, and blue and listen to that national anthem. And if you wanna protest, then go do that on your own time.
During the 1968 Olympic Games, John Carlos and Tommy Smith raised their black fists in the air. Just like me, they were punished.
And now on November 1st, that same committee will be inducting these two men into the U.S. Olympic and Paralympic Hall of Fame. I guess better late than never, huh?
It's hypocritical.
You know, it's interesting what Jason said, too. I mean, who does she represent? Does anybody feel like she represents them, is the question.
They say, oh, no, you can't talk about racial discrimination in black and brown neighborhoods. Oh, that's not for you to talk about. But that athlete is literally a product of the system.
From above, from weekend, Gwen Berry, who hopes to represent the United States as an Olympian on the hammer throwing events, won a bronze medal at the trials, and then she turned her back on the flag while the anthem played. Does President Biden think that is appropriate behavior for someone who hopes to represent Team USA?
Well, Peter, I haven't spoken to the president specifically about this, but I know he's incredibly proud to be an American and has great respect for the anthem and all that it represents, especially for our men and women serving in uniform all around the world. He would also say, of course, that part of that pride in our country means recognizing there are moments where we are, as a country, haven't lived up to our highest ideals. And it means respecting the right of people granted to them in the Constitution to peacefully protest.